Hi everyone, Reinhard here, and in this video I demonstrate how you can strip down your GoPro Hero 6 Black and save a lot of weight to use the camera on your ultralight FPV drone like the Beta 95X. Before tearing down your GoPro, please make sure that you have firmware 1.6 installed. I've just released a video on my channel on how to do this. The next thing you need to do is to activate the Wi-Fi. First, you should change the Wi-Fi band to 2.4, otherwise it could interfere with your FPV system. And then connect a new device and use the GoPro app. Because as we remove the screen of the camera, this is the only way we can adjust the settings. So here it is found now. Here we can connect. Here, as you can see, we can change all the settings. Now we can turn it off. Just as a reference, we can now weigh the camera to see how much weight we save in the end. So the GoPro Hero 6 weighs about 117 or 118 grams. And the first thing we can do is we remove the battery. And just the battery itself weighs about 25 grams. And we don't need it because we will power the camera then in the FPV quad. And we also remove then the SD card. The next thing we remove is this port cover. Just clip it off. The next thing we remove is this lens cover here. And usually you can just twist it off, but if it is not coming off, you can use a screwdriver to give it a bit of space and then twist it off, like so. And now comes the most tricky part of the whole teardown, which is removing this front cover here. This is a bit tricky because there is a lot of glue underneath. And to soften the glue, I use a USB heating band, which is used for lens heating, so that you prevent it from fogging. And I think this is just enough to make it warm a bit. It's not too hot. You can also use a heating gun, but you have to be careful not to destroy the electronics inside. And this is not very hot, but just warm enough to maybe soften the glue underneath. And I do this now for a few minutes. You can also record for some time and then it gets also warm from inside. When this is done, you can try to insert something here. Maybe a screwdriver or a plectrum or whatever you have. Just to get in. And then more or less cutting through the glue. What I use here is my the thickest plectrum I have. And here you should be very careful because there is a ribbon cable underneath. For example, if you have a 5-inch probe, you can also try to use this. And I also have another kind of silicone. Maybe this works. Just like that. And theoretically, if you break it, it's not an issue because we won't need it. But here you can see I could remove it just in one piece. And here you can see the ribbon cable I just mentioned. Here you can see now that there are 6 bolts here that we have to open now. And you need a T4 screwdriver. And now it should work that we can carefully wheel it out. And here you can see there are quite some ribbon cables that we can disconnect. There's a pair of tweezers, for example. And there is also one at the top here with the 4 cables. Okay, so now we have here the case with the back screen. So I can remove those. And here we have now the main board. And we also want to remove the front plate with the display and just use the main board and the lens. So first thing, we can also disconnect this ribbon cable here. We can remove this tape here. This is just an anchor point. I end up breaking it, but this is not a problem. Don't need it. Like so. And here you can also see it. 1, 2, 3 bolts here, one in the corner, 4, and underneath this here, there is also 1 or 2 bolts. So we remove the tape here also. Remove this part here, just, I don't know what this is. Now we can remove these bolts. This one here. So here you can see there is one hidden screw here, and to get to this we just need to unplug this ribbon cable here, and we also want to disconnect this part here. So this is now the USB-C connector, and there is again a hidden bolt here for this black bracket. Take this off, and this here is the camera sensor, so we have to be careful. Just unplug this one. As this is done, we can now remove the main board. And this is what we want. Now the only thing missing is the camera, and there is one small screw beneath this ribbon cable here, and now we should be able to remove this. So here is the front display, and we don't need it. So the only two things we need is this main board here and the lens. You can clean up this a bit, removing this. Like so. And just to get an idea, just these two parts weigh about 16 grams, which is really cool. So now that we have our two parts we need from the GoPro, the main board and the lens, we want to assemble it into this case from Better FPV. This is now the version 2, which is injection molded and a lot easier to install than the version 1. And here you can see it, we have these two buttons to turn on the GoPro and to start recording. And we also gonna need this small board from Better FPV also, where we have the two buttons. First we can add the lens again, plug in the sensor, which is a bit tricky to be honest. When this is done, you can add the board here. Just align the screw holes and plug it in here at the corner. Then take the front from the case. And wiggle the lens through here. Then you can also check if the buttons work. And then you need a M4 screw here, which comes with the case. Then you need a M4x5 and use it in this corner here. And the second one in this corner here. And don't over tighten it, because you are screwing into a plastic part and you don't want to break it. Again, try if the buttons work. And then you need two longer bolts, the M4x8. Same bolt on this corner here. And by the way, you can remove this cover here, because you need this plug here then for the powering. And here for the rear of the case, we need to first add this transparent part here, which in the end shows us then if we are recording or not, because there is this LED behind. And this is a bit tricky, you need to be completely straight to insert this. Like so. So it was a bit tricky, because there is no lead-in chamfer or something. But yeah, finally I got it in. And now the only thing missing is just put it together. And now just use the last 6 screws to finally assemble it. So now it's finished, and here we can then plug the power of the cord. Here you can press the buttons, here you can see if this is recording or not. And yeah, you could even plug in the screen if you don't want to use your phone. And yeah, here is access for the SD card. And if we measure now the weight of this naked GoPro, it is 26 grams, which is pretty cool. So we saved about 90 grams. And what is also interesting is if we measure the weight of the 95X, for example, we have a weight of 116 grams, which is exactly the weight of the GoPro Hero 6 before stripping down. And if we add the battery, we have 170 grams. And if we add the naked GoPro, we have 196 grams or 195 grams. So just under 200 grams, which is pretty cool for a 4K FPV drone. I hope you find this video helpful. If so, please give it a thumbs up and also consider subscribing to my channel. Thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye!